Hello, hello, sisters and brothers. My name is Tracy, coming right back to share another beautiful word with you guys. Okay, God is so good. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Okay, God is so amazing. So listen, you guys, this is a word. I will be talking about a wealthy place. And the Lord dropped that in my spirit yesterday. I bet it's in my notes somewhere, but I'm saying it now. The Lord dropped that in my spirit yesterday while I was sitting in the parking lot, you know, still from delivering the first word. I still, you know, kind of stay there a little bit, spend time, see if the Lord wants to say anything else. Right now, this is my quiet place in the car to record and sometimes to study. But anyways, God is so good. So listen, I'm not coming on here to tickle anybody's fancy. I am coming here to give you a word from the Lord. Amen, amen. Those who know me, y'all know that. Amen. Listen, I don't know. I know I put it in a community post, but I don't know if I said thank you so much for helping me to get the car out of the mud. And y'all know how I feel. I don't want to ask. I don't want to ask. And I was not going to. And I'm like, and I had an appointment the next day. You know what I'm saying? And so I'm like, okay, Lord, you know, it's in your hands. You already know. You already know what I need to do. And the Lord will require us to ask. Sometimes he say, just ask, because he's laying it on somebody's heart. He already know who's going to be that blessing to you. So thank you so much. I don't want to call any names, but thank you. Thank you. You know who you are. And I love y'all so much for coming through for me and for believing in me. I do mean what I say. I do mean my life. I'm not playing with God. I mean him all the way. He is my everything. Hallelujah. God is my everything. Amen. Amen. Let's get into this word. Hallelujah. God is so amazing. So listen, one, the camels are truly coming. I just want to say that. Okay, that dropped into my spirit yesterday. The camels are coming. The camels are coming. And yes, I've seen it somewhere as well. But hey, I just want to put that out there first. So listen, God is about to bless us abundantly. And I'm going to do my best to take my time. I'm going to be looking down as I usually do anyway, because that's where my notes are. And so God is about to bless us financially. Y'all, we need money. I hate that it's such an issue because we can't talk about money in the body of Christ. It makes no sense. And yet we live in a world that requires, that takes money to do things. It takes money to eat. It takes money to live, to get housing. You know what I'm saying? It takes money to go to place where God has called us to deliver the word or whatever it is that he's having us to do. It takes money. And yet many people, not just the body of Christ, but many people only think that people that are Christians that are saved, all we want is money. We need money just like everybody else to live and to do things, right? It is a requirement. It is the love of money that's the issue. That's the word of God. So listen, look, and the Bible says to give to those in need. And then it says over in the New Testament, I don't have the scripture. I'm going to try to remember to put it in the description box. Y'all know how that goes. But it says, especially to the household of faith, especially. Okay, so look, I just want to put that out there. That's not in my notes. That's for free. Amen. Amen. So listen, so last night, / this morning, I had a couple of dreams. Okay. I had a couple of dreams and it's funny too, because the first dream, I don't really remember. I don't remember the details. And I was like, Holy Spirit, what, bring it back to me. You know, I was sensing that something is in it, but you know, if God wants you to remember, he'll bring it back to you. Let me tell you what the Lord did. Even though he did not give me back the details of the dream, he let me know the first dream that I had was about guidance, was about him guiding me to a place. It dropped so beautifully in my spirit. Okay. And you know what, that he's my guide. Now I'm going to mention the name of a renowned pastor, a bishop. And I'm only doing it because his name is significant, right? Otherwise, I don't really like to share names on here unless God is leading me to, but this is call for it. So in both of these dreams, in the one that I was being led, I dreamt about Bishop Noel Jones. Okay. He's a wonderful preacher. I enjoy hearing him. I don't know anything bad about to say about him. But anyways, that's what God gave me. That's what I'm giving you guys. So whatever your opinions are or whatever, you know, take them to the Lord. Okay. In Jesus' name. Okay. So in both dreams, he was in my dream, right? Even in the first one, I knew that I was walking with him somewhere. You know what I'm saying? So that's all I remember. Like I said, I don't remember the details, but the Lord let me know that God was guiding me. He was representing the Lord in this dream. Okay. And so he's guiding me to a place. Thank you, Lord, for your guidance. And in the second dream, I remembered. Okay. I remembered. I picked up my phone all groggy and just spoke into it so that I would not forget, you know, the details of it. So this might be a long word. So y'all just, you'll see that, of course. I'm just letting you know. Yeah. And you can see it. I don't even know why we say that, because once the video's up, you know how long it is. Okay. Anyways, let's get into the second dream. So the second dream, Bishop Noel Jones, he is the pastor of City of Refuge Church in LA. Okay. This is what God gave me. Let me go find my notes here. So in the second dream, the bishop was sitting on a bed. Okay. He was sitting on a bed and he was writing a check. I remember my sister being there. My sister, Nikki, that's my eldest sister. We call her Nikki. That's a nickname. Her name is Mother Linda Jones. Okay. And she was there too. She was standing like here on the side. Okay. And Bishop was sitting on the bed and he was writing a check for $128,000, 128K. Okay. I'm like, okay. And it wasn't nothing odd. You guys, let's keep our minds, just because it's a bed and dreams doesn't mean it's anything of sexual nature. So let's clean up if your mind went there automatically. Okay. And I remember stepping up on the bed, walking around behind him, right, to give him a hug from the back. And I remember saying, not wanting him to think that the affection I was showing him was because of the money that he was giving me, right? The $128,000. And so I remember that. I also remember, so as I walked around the back of him on the bed, because I stood up with my feet on the bed and walked around, and then I knelt down and gave him a hug from the back. I remember thinking, or either I said, I can't remember, that the show of affection was not because of the money that he was giving me, but because I loved him, you know? It was a genuine feeling, okay? And so I remember the bishop smiling. Let me find my notes here. I want to make sure I get this right. I remember, let me see, you guys. Okay, I remember that he smiled at me and kept writing the check. Just a small smile, okay? Let's see, that's it. He was giving me the money. Okay, and I woke up. I think that's the gist of the dream, okay? So you guys, if you didn't catch that, just kind of rewind and play it again. And so what God was revealing to me through this dream is that he is giving a substantial, okay, financial blessing. 128K may not be a lot to some people, but check it out. Oh, it will do me good. Now, I know that it's just not the actual number. It represents a substantial financial blessing, okay? Not necessarily the 128. With all that being said, I'll take it. Amen. So the Lord was letting me know that, and also the Lord was letting me know that he knows that my love was genuine, that it was coming from a pure heart, from a place of just love for the Lord. Okay. And the Lord knew that it has nothing to do with, money, you know, nothing to do with the financial blessing. My love for him is genuine. The Lord was letting me know that. And also, a bed or a bedroom in dreams often represents, it's a place of intimacy, right? And you guys know that intimacy is not always about sex. And so, of course, in this place, in this dream, is not talking about sex, okay? I was hugging him and explaining that it wasn't because of the money. See, God knows the very intent of our heart, right? There was no need for me to explain because God knew my heart. And so the Lord was letting me know that this morning. So like I said, in the dream, Bishop Noah Jones smiled and kept writing the check because he knew the hug and the display of affection had nothing to do with the money, but it was genuine. Isn't that so beautiful? I was so blessed this morning. I was so blessed by the dream. I'm like, God, you are so good. He's so amazing. Listen, God is a faithful God. He loves us. All right. He loves us. And it's just good. So listen, so Noel, means the firstborn of God, which is Jesus. And we know that Jesus is the firstborn, his only begotten son. Amen. But Noel is also associated with Christmas. Now listen, before anyone have anything negative to say, y'all, this does not have anything to do with the way some people or society celebrates Christmas or the Christmas tree. I don't even do the Christmas tree, okay? That's just my personal thing between me and God. So it is representative of a day of celebration of the birth of Jesus Christ. Now, that's before the world or society tainted it. Christmas used to be a pure, not the Christmas tree. I'm talking about the day itself that we chose to set aside. We know Jesus was not born on December 25th. However, it was a day that we used to celebrate the birth of Christ and the giving of gifts, right? It has been so tainted and so messed up. The Lord already dealt with me about Christmas. This is a personal thing. You take it to the Lord. I don't need to know in the comments what you feel about it or anything else. It is between you and God. So as for me, God does not have me celebrate Christmas. And so last year during Christmas time, I struggled with that. So I turned the comments off because everybody was saying Merry Christmas and I didn't want to be rude and not say it back. So I just took the comments off because I'm like, I'm not trying to be disobedient to God, but I also didn't want anybody to feel type of way that I was being rude. So anyway, that's a whole nother thing. I just wanted to put that out there. So listen, that's a whole nother message for a whole nother day. Okay. So, I'm just going to give you what God gave me. So anyway, so this here represents, Noel is represents the giving of gifts. That's what the Lord was just letting me know. He is going to give us a beautiful and a big and a substantial gift. He was just letting me know. This is one of many, you guys. This particular message has to do with wealth, monetary. I'm going to make it very clear and very plain. Money, period. Money, we need it. And we have gone through so much. Many have left houses and family and our credit is jacked up. You know, some of us had to break leases. Okay. And I'm like, God, how am I going to get another place when my lease broke? All right. And so my credit is jacked up. Okay. I was already taking care of it, but you know what? All I was doing what God says. I know some people may not believe that, but watch God restore all of that. And then some. That's what the Lord is talking about here. Okay. So that's it. And then also, his last name, Jones, excuse me, means God is gracious and Jehovah has favored. I'm not even going to explain it. That is so self-explanatory. God is gracious and Jehovah has favored. Ooh, talking about the favor of God resting upon our lives. Those that have been obedient and faithful. We're not, I like to remind us, it is not about perfection because we human, we mess up a little bit. But our heart towards God. That's what we're talking about. Trying to do everything he tells to do. Crying and everything. Talking about, God, this is hard, but thy will be done. All right, God is gracious. And he has. And he's about to favor us real good. It's coming. I knew I heard him yesterday. Okay. Ooh, talking about a wealthy place. A wealthy place. Amen. Amen. Let me keep going because I don't want to stay there. So financial blessings are coming. They are not small, y'all. They are not small, y'all. Okay, I'm so excited because I am so tired of the struggle. Listen, you guys, I have been looking for a job and I, you know, God gonna do what he do. The Lord doesn't really have me work. Usually when I work, it is for a short amount of time, 6 months typically max. And sometimes it was just shorter than that. I'm like, Lord, what? You know what? And so I've been looking for work. All right. On the DL, my sister seen me the first time yesterday looking for a job. But I had already been looking for work. I'm like, I have to work. God, I need, you know, some money to sustain myself better. I don't like asking. I really don't. And I want to be self-sufficient. And so I have been looking at work and looking for work and looking for work. And I ain't found nothing yet. So praise the Lord. So I'm tired of the struggle. So I'm looking forward to this huge, substantial is the word, substantial financial blessing. All right, let's read some scripture that the Lord took me to. All right, 1 Kings chapter 10, verses 1 and 2, NIV. It says, when the queen of Sheba heard about the fame of Solomon and his relationship to the Lord, okay? His relationship to the Lord. She came to test Solomon with hard questions. Arriving at Jerusalem with a very great caravan with camels carrying spices and large quantities of gold and precious stones. I'm just going to start right there. Verse number one, his relationship with the Lord. Remember in my dream, it showed the intimacy, the closeness, okay, I had with the Lord, and it was genuine. I was not out looking for monetary or things that God can give me. The relationship and my heart toward God was genuine, okay? Here it says, his relationship with the Lord. All right, Solomon had a relationship with the Lord. Remember in the scripture, he said he wasn't even asking for riches. He was asking for wisdom on how to go in and out before God's children, before God's people. How do you want me to minister to your people? That's what Solomon was asking, and God gave him riches, and nobody's had it like that since. Y'all read the scripture, okay? The second verse, she came, the queen of Sheba came with camels. It says carrying large quantities, y'all hear that, of gold and precious stones. So in my dream, the check was for $128,000, representing it not being any little bit or chump change, okay? Sorry, you guys, I forgot to turn off my notification. It was not chump change. The Lord was giving me, has been giving me several numbers, okay? And I mean, I'm like, you know how the Lord can really speak so much and it becomes overwhelming. You have to like pause and say, Father, I have to try to get this down because it can be so much. I know I'm not the only one. I'm like, Lord, I don't know. You know, he can give you a download of a lot of information and speaking a lot of things. And so the Lord has been giving me quite a few numbers for several weeks. One of the numbers was number 128, 128, okay? And in the dream, see, 128K came up again. And I can't remember where else it was coming up, but I'm like 128, it keeps coming up. So Psalms 128, 1 and 2, it says, blessed is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in his ways. You shall eat the fruit of your labor. Okay, of the labor of your hands. Listen, you guys, you shall be blessed and it shall be well with you. Amen. Hallelujah. It is going to be well with you. This struggle is only for a season. Now, our season's different from God's, okay? At the end of the day, God is going to do exactly what he say. Another number, which I have mentioned before, is the number 320. I am still seeing 320. I'm seeing 320 on license plate, on views, on scriptures. So for example, if the scripture is 13 and 20, there's still 320 in it. You know what I'm saying? And of course, Ephesians 3 and 20. I'm just seeing it a lot of places, okay? So let's read Ephesians 3 and 20. Now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think according to the power that works in us. I gotta read the Amplified, okay? Because I love the Amplified. It says, now unto him who is able to carry out his purpose and do super abundantly more than all that we dare ask or think, infinitely beyond, hallelujah, infinitely beyond our greatest prayers, hopes, or dreams, according to his power that is at work within us. You guys better come on and praise God. Hallelujah. Y'all know I'll run around, okay? I will get out my car and run like a crazy woman in this parking lot. Don't care who's looking. All right, you can look at me all you want. I will get out and dance for God. Hallelujah. Look, don't tempt me. Hey. Okay. Whew, bring it in, Tracy. Hallelujah. God is so good. He has not forgotten about us. He knows. He will reward us. His word says so. Not because we're out seeking riches. God said it is part of the promise. Amen. Amen. Let's get on. Another number that the Lord keeps showing me is the number 912. And I wish I would have went back to see. So let me see. So I wrote down on January 28th, I said, the Lord has been giving me the number 912 for several days now. So that was even before January 28th. Listen, you guys, there's that 128 again. I'm just not thinking about that. See that? That's when I first started taking notes on the number 912. But the Lord had given me it prior to that. Amen. Amen. So listen, so the number 912, I have been seeing it everywhere as well, on videos, the time, on license plate. Listen, you guys, I was watching an animation with my daughter, and it was the Meet the Robinsons, okay? And that's my maiden name. Anyways, and I seen the number 912 on this little hat thing. Let me tell you something. I believe I was waking up and my eyes caught the TV and I happened to see 912. I'm like, seriously? And so what I did was the day after or something like that, I went back. I said, I seen the number 912. Was it on the door? Because I was kind of half asleep and it was a little number on a hat. I'm like, how? Only the Holy Spirit can point that out. I was like, how in the world I see that? Well, it wasn't me, Tracy. It wasn't you, Tracy. It was the Holy Spirit showing you that number. Okay, so then the next day after I went to look it up to see exactly where I seen the number 912, my sister and I was watching a movie. We love the classics. I told you guys before, I love, love, love my black and white movies, okay? And so on this movie I was watching, and so this guy was at the counter. I don't know if he was buying flowers, whatever it was, but the receipt, on his receipt, the timestamp was 912. Y'all better listen to what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. Let's get into it. Okay, amen, amen. So the first scripture the Lord gave me was Genesis 9 and 12. And I'm going to read the New Living Translation, NLT. It says, then God said, I am giving you a sign of my covenant. Hallelujah. With you and with all living creatures for all generations to come. God is so amazing. Listen, brothers and sisters, God has given us a promise, right? He has made a covenant with us, just as he did with Noah. He put the rainbow up in the sky, promising never to flood the entire world again, the earth again, right? And so his promise, he put the rainbow up there so that when you see it and when Noah seen it, he will remember the promise, the covenant God had made with him. Amen. Let me tell y'all something. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. Okay, listen. God has given us a sign as well. Okay, I don't know about you, but for me, I'm gonna tell you the sign God gives me. One of the signs that the Lord gave me is the number 111. When I see the number 111, that is God reminding me of all of his promises to me, all of them. He's just letting me know, Tracy, I remember you. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Woo, y'all. God is amazing. So he's letting me know that I haven't forgotten about you. All right. Amen. That's letting me know. That's across the board. 111 reminds me. I know what it means in the Strong's Concordance or whatever God gave you. But for me, that's why we got to seek him. That's why we have to have a personal relationship with him so that you know how he speaks to you. All right. Amen. So 111, I know that is all of the promises across the board. Now, again, general sign. So God also will give me, he will also give me a specific number representing a specific promise. Y'all surely have had the experience, right? Amen. Amen. So that's all I'm gonna say about that. So it represents a specific promise. Okay. And I had the nerve to write down specific. Okay. I said it right, but I just didn't write it right. Okay. A specific promise. Amen. You guys, I'm going to turn on my air a little bit. Give me just a second because sister girl is starting to sweat and I can't have that. So give me just a minute because I got to get some air on. Woo. Man, these hot flashes just don't get along. No way. It's such a beautiful day, even after all the rain for the past 5 days. It's beautiful out. The sun is shining in sunny California. Okay. So the next scripture God gave me was Zechariah 9 and 12, and it's also NLT. This is what it says. Come back to the place of safety, all you prisoners who still have hope. Y'all still have hope? I still have hope. As tired as I can be some days, and as hard as some things are, I still have hope. I need you to keep your hope alive. Amen. Amen. It says, I promise. This is the word of God. This is what God is saying. He says, I promise this very day. This is present tense. Okay. I promise this very day that I will repay two blessings. Hallelujah. Two blessings. Can y'all say that? Two blessings. Okay. For each of your troubles. Y'all read that scripture again. I'm not going to read it over. Or should I? I'm going to read it one more time for you all the way through. Amen. Come back to the place of safety, all you prisoners who still have hope. I promise this very day that I will repay two blessings for each of your troubles. We already know, double for your trouble. Did y'all hear that? Amen, amen, amen. God says, I promise this very day, represents present tense, that I will pay two, double for your trouble. Amen, amen, for each of your troubles, okay? Y'all better get excited about the word of God. He's a promise keeper. Hallelujah. God is a promise keeper, all right? We see it all through the Bible. He is a promise keeper. God is not a man that he should lie. Amen, 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 amen. Okay, lastly, for the number 12, is Isaiah 9 verses 1 and 2. You guys see it? 9, 1, 2. It's still there. It reads, nevertheless, there will be no more gloom. Hallelujah. For those who were in distress. In past, he humbled the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali. Okay? That was the wilderness process. All right? We needed to be humble, you guys, right? And refined in that time. All right? But it says, this is what it says. But in the future, okay, for some of us, this time is now, okay? But in the future, he will honor Galilee of the nations by the way of the sea beyond Jordan. Okay, let me stop right there. Listen, what's beyond Jordan? What's beyond Jordan? Is that not the way to the promised land? It is. Just read Joshua. Chapter is what? 3 through 5. Actually, just read the book of Joshua. I recommend that. Listen to what Joshua 5 and 12 says. This is what it's, well, I'm not going to read the whole thing, but in Joshua 5 and 12, it says they ate the produce of Canaan, the promised land, right? Y'all read your word. Let's go to verse 2. So verse 2, remember verse 2, it says, the people walking in darkness have seen a great light. Okay, on those living in the land of deep darkness, because we have been in a place of distress and darkness. We could not see our way sometimes. Y'all can relate. I know it. I'm like, God, I cannot see. That's why my t-shirt was like eyes closed, faith eyes, because we couldn't see a thing. We just had to walk by faith and not by sight. Amen. Okay, it says the people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of deep darkness, listen to this. This is the part that really got me. It says a light has dawned. Let me tell you something. After I read that part, somebody looking at me because I'm so excited and I'm facing the street and the sidewalk. That's okay. Y'all come catch this word. Amen. And so listen, after I read that part, whew, this is blessing my socks off. Y'all blessed? Okay, I'm blessed. Okay, when I read the last part, it said a light has dawned. The Holy Spirit dropped in my spirit the dawn of a new day. The dawn of a new day. Listen, I have to look it up. So I looked up the phrase, a dawn of a new day. And the first thing that came up hit my spirit real, real good. Okay, it says a new beginning. So a dawn of a new day is a new beginning, a fresh start, an important, promising turning point. If y'all didn't catch that, I'm sorry. Okay, because it is messing me up. A new beginning, a fresh start, an important, promising turning point. Okay, it's turning around for me. Hallelujah. Can't sing. I'm not even going to start. But there's a song. It's turning around for me. This is a turning point. A dawn of a new day. The promise of God. Oh my God. Hallelujah. God is so good. I should just get out and dance for y'all. Hey. But I could just in a car. Hey. Okay. So listen here. Wait, you know what? Listen, you guys. I remember something. I don't know what day it was, but it wasn't too long ago. When I woke up, I heard the song. Let me find this song. Wait a minute, you guys. Okay, so one morning when I woke up, and this, I don't even know, I'm familiar with the song, but this is only part I know. That's why God gave me only this part. This was applied. Listen, it says, "Tell me what you want and tell me what you need" by Drew Hill. Listen, don't look up all the lyrics. This is the part God gave me. I should have bought my laptop just so I can play that little clip. "Tell me what you want. Tell me what you need." Okay, amen and amen. God is amazing. And I forgot to write down Philippians 4:6. Y'all hang on while I get my Bible. I wanted another translation, but we're going to do King James today. Because why? Because that's all I got. Until I get my little, my Bible game up a little more. Okay. Let me see here. Y'all hold on. Because I'm taking my time today. I know y'all praying for me. So listen, so that's the song again by Drew Hill. "Tell me what you want, tell me what you need." And as soon as I woke up, that's what I heard. That's what the Lord dropped in my spirit. Let me tell you, God will speak to you however he wants to. Don't box him in, y'all. Okay? You're missing out on a lot if you do that. So Philippians 4:6, it says this. It says, "Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God." Okay, the Lord was telling me, "Tell me what you want. Tell me what you need." And I sure did. Okay, I let him know. I had a little list going. Okay, because I got some things before the Lord right now. Amen, amen. So let's move on. Last but not least, okay, we're wrapping it up now, you guys. Last but not least, I know somebody really need to hear this. It was just in my spirit, okay? I have also been seeing the number 44 and the number 444. I woke up this morning at 444 this morning. I said, okay, let's go, Lord. I knew that he had a word. So Isaiah, this is where he took me to. Isaiah 44 verses 1 through 4, and I'm going to read the ESV. It says, "But now hear, O Jacob, my servant, O Jacob, my servant, Israel, from whom I chosen. Thus says the Lord, who made you, who formed you from the womb, and will help you." God will help you. God will help you. The number 44, especially if you've been seeing the number 44. God will help you. He is your help. Okay? Amen. It says, "Fear not, O Jacob, my servant, Jeshurun, whom I have chosen, for I will pour water on the thirsty land and streams on the dry ground. I will pour my spirit upon your offsprings and my blessing upon your descendants." Okay, this blessing will be generational. Amen. "They shall spring up among the grass like willows by flowing streams." Okay, you guys go read Isaiah 44 verses 1 through 4, whichever translation God wants to speak it to you. All right. And again, I've been seeing the number 44 and 444. Now, we know that can mean different things for different people, because the Lord has given me the number 444 for other things. Okay. Anyways, that's the message. I'm not going to go on. It blessed my socks off. I hope y'all socks was blessed off. I told one sister, I was like, "We running out of socks." No, but yeah. God is so good. God is so good. We losing a lot of socks. And right now, in my car, it's telling me the average miles. I have the numbers 111. And I probably can't even, I'm not even going to take it off and show you. You just got to take my word for it. Okay. 111 right there. I'm looking at it. 11.1. That said it's average because it reset itself. 111. He's still reminding me of every promise that he promised me will come to pass. And same for you. You all be blessed. Let me get out of here. Listen, if you're new in Christ, enjoy your new life with him, sweetheart. It is the best decision that you could ever make. All heaven is rejoicing with you. If by chance you have fallen away and you just now coming back, check it out. The most important thing is that you're back now. I celebrate with you. Enjoy your renewed life with Christ, okay? It is the best decision that you could ever make. And yes, all heaven is rejoicing with you too. May the Spirit of the living God, that is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, rest upon you and your family. You all be blessed. I love you so much. And Jesus loves you so much more. You guys, really quick. Look, I got these cute little butterflies on my finger. I love butterflies. And they're blue. Okay? Hey, that's for somebody. Listen, you guys, I love you, and Jesus loves you so much more. Take care, all right? Listen, the wealth is coming. Take this word back to the Lord. It is important that you know what season that you're in. But hey, them blessings are coming. The struggle is over. This is the dawn of a new day. I love y'all so much, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.